Is Ollie Robinson racist? Is Ollie Robinson sexist? Is Ollie Robinson Islamophobic? Is Ollie Robinson lesbian? These are the questions, billion rupee questions everyone is asking, but does anyone have any answers? Well, in case you have missed the shitstorm, also known as Robinson Gate, let me fill you in. All right, here's what happened. 2nd June morning was the greatest day for Ollie Robinson's career. He debuted for England in a test match, not a fucking T20, a test match, all right? Now, by the time the sun set on the 2nd June, the greatest day turned out to be a bloody nightmare for Ollie Robinson's career. A series of allegedly sexist, racist, Islamophobic tweets were brought back from the dead that Robinson had posted 9 years ago in 2012. He was 18 years old at that time. Please remember that. All right, at that moment, let's check out all these tasty tweets. Vikram, I'm feeling super hungry, so I'm gonna munch on these tweets. Mm-hmm. Let's find out if they're really as tasty, I mean, terrible, as they're made out to be. Now, the first one I'm looking at, it says, my new Muslim friend is a bomb. Way. So I don't know, this is like a advertisement for Way, the protein people eat. And,
yeah.
But honestly speaking, this is like it's an interesting wordplay. I mean, and if you're 13 years old and if you're not very sensitive and you're not like, you think everybody's after you, I think it's funny for a 13-year-old kid. Now, the second one it says is, wonder if Asian people put smileys like this. So, okay. Mm-hmm. Also, the fact that a lot of Asians are different. We are like Indian Asians, so we don't even have eyes like that, right? So, we can't even put it. But this is a very, very old joke that I have probably heard like forever in my life. And even my father must have been doing this joke. So, it's super unoriginal. Then the third one says, females who play video games actually tend to have more sex. Okay, if I was 15, I would say, if this is true, I'm going to make every girl play a video game. So this is like, this is what I'm going to think. This is a teenage shit, right? And then the fourth one is, not going to lie. Lie is like, jhoot nahi bolunga. A lot of girls need to learn the class, art of class. Well, I feel it's an opinion. And again, I don't feel it's racist. Now, people are like, you don't care about anything. Okay, let me see. First one, it says, my new Muslim friend is a bomb. Now, that's just wordplay and it's just a quirky thing. I don't think it's racist. Why? I'll tell you what is racist. All Muslims are terrorists. Now, that is racist. Now, it's saying, my new Muslim friend is a bomb. This is just a wordplay. Okay, and sensitive people will hate everything. Fine. And then the last one, which says, which people are calling sexist, not going to lie, a lot of girls need to learn the art of class. It's an opinion. If you change the word, because just to test why something is sexist, if you change the word from the girl to boys and then see how the impact is. Not going to lie, a lot of guys, boys, need to learn art of class. And if a girl says this, nobody will accuse her for being racist, right? So this is the way. If he had said, girls can't play cricket, girls can't play football, that's sexist, because this is not sexist. Now, there's one more tweet, Bikram, before I give the mic over to you in whatever your mask form right now you're in, trying to hide your face, which I can totally understand. You don't want anybody to know, but I'll let you speak and justify your abomination of a face that you have right now. Okay, and thank you for people for noticing that I've had a haircut and I've removed my baseball cap. All right, now there's one more tweet which whose text hasn't been revealed. It is, apparently it says, it has the dreaded N-word. Now, this N-word always baffles me, you know, because it becomes the most offensive word if it's used by a person who is white. But it turns into a term of endearment whenever a black person uses it. Because I find it completely ridiculous, Vikram, because black people keep telling everybody that they're same as white people. And then the same breath, hypocritically, they say they can use the N-word because they are black. For fuck's sake, my, get real. You can't have it both ways. I mean, that just kind of, I find it bizarre. And at the same time, if he's used the N-word, he shouldn't be using it, but nobody should be using it. Bikram, now please tell me, why are you wearing this goddamn mask? And please give us your opinion on this tweet, sweet tweets.
Yeah, now you've already ruined the reason why I was wearing this mask. I ruin everything.
That's how I am.
Yeah, that's true. But because I was trying to hide my... hide my identity. I'm going back and deleting my social media account, or at least deleting all the tweets and everything. And I'll also go through all our videos and see whether I have been racist, homophobic. I don't know. There are like 100 types of words like this. So I'll try to run through. I'm making a program which will run through all these videos and find anything which is offensive and flag it, so that in future I am safe. Because I am really scared, to be really honest, because we are out here giving our opinion to everyone and we say stuff. And if in future, someone might come and, you know, dig up a 10-year-old video and say that, see this guy, out of context, they can put a short clip of our podcast and say that, see this guy is a racist, see this guy is a, I don't know, white supremacist, I don't know what.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Other day I said I touched that baby's heart, and then they'll say, I'll just touch that baby. That's how they'll keep it.
Yeah. So yeah. It's just scary, and it's I mean, right now it was idiotic for some time, but now it is becoming real. Now it is becoming a real problem. It's affecting people, real people's career, real people's life. And this is really scary because this will never stop. This will keep on going. As we say, the snowflake generation will always find something to get offended about, and there's no turning back anymore, I think.
All right, Faizan, you talked about snowflake generation, and I hate you for that because they are my favorite generation. Now, I am brown, as you can guys can see. Obviously, I put a lot of lotion and try to make myself white. I have a lot of dark eyes, and I have chunky, because you can't say fat anymore. Fat is wrong. So you say chunky. So I've been calling girls chunky now. So people be chunky. Oh, that sounds nice, but I'm just calling them fat. So, but that's the, okay. Let's talk about, like, I'm just thinking that if I see a tweet by Mr. Robinson or any punk out there, say, they might say stuff like, oh, all Asians are mama's boys, all Asians are snake charmers, all Asians are filthy bastards because you wipe their hand, your ass with your hands, which we do, obviously. We don't use toilet paper, which I feel is like probably nicer. I don't know. But I won't get offended by these weird claims because it's crystal to me that this is fucking horseshit, right? It doesn't matter. Yeah. I can't get offended by a fucking hormonal teenager's tweet, because in a world of social media where millions of tweets are posted each second minute, because if I'm going to get offended by each tweet that I see, if I can start getting my panties in a bunch every single time, and something is not as nice, Bikram, I'm going to fucking lose my head, mate. I'm just going to lose my head. Bikram, I hope you're not becoming one of those people who get up every morning and start searching internet. It's like, what is there to be offended? What is it? What do you do? How do you stop? Like, what is your opinion on this snowflake generation? Anything?
Yeah, I think it's just the easy availability of everything that has ruined this, or, this is destroying the generation. I think we have done a podcast on a documentary called The Social Dilemma, which never came out, which will come out eventually.
You just reminded me, now I hate you so much. Yeah.
but you can see that it's just people are so absorbed in their phones, they don't even know what's going on in the real life. They're really disconnected. This generation is really disconnected from the reality. They don't even know where their food is coming from. They don't even know where their clothes are being made. They just know, if they just get all their information from social media, and social media is just becoming worse and worse. People here are just, and this incident is, because when social media started, it was just a place to, just chill out and, be yourself, or muck around and all that.
Now, cat videos.
Cat videos. I mean, the first YouTube video was about a zoo. The founder of YouTube posted a video.
Yeah, I've seen it. Yeah. What a terrible video that is.
So it started from there, and now you see it is changing lives for better or worse.
Fair enough. So let's talk about the apology, right? And there are a few concerns about the apology. Now, Robinson, instantly on the same day, he came out, he gave an unreserved apology. He did not say, because this happened, I was a teenager. He said, I am embarrassed, I am ashamed. Okay. He also went on to say that over the years, he has changed for the better, and he will continue to educate himself. Now, I know what the cynics would say, that he had no choice but to give an unreserved apology because he's in a shitstorm and he can't. And I'm a cynical cunt, so I totally agree. I totally agree. Now, the only way we can find out if his words are just fucking just horseshit or these are like real words, we have to put it through an acid test. Now, let me take it from the record. It's not my opinion. This is truth. So after those 2012-13 tweets are there, in 2014, Robinson was actually sacked from his county, Yorkshire, for unprofessional conduct. So that means this person was not just an ass on the internet, he was also ass on professional life, real life, and he had problems. And this became his watershed moment, a moment of truth. Either he now completely sinks or he lifts and levitates himself. Do not levitate by acid and cocaine, just by doing well. Now, when we see the last 7 years, and Robinson, instead of being an ass, has worked his ass off, and he's resurrected his career. Not just resurrected, he's been an absolute success at Sussex since 2015 when he joined them for the last 6 years. And his performances over there have been brilliant. So yeah, as you can see on that, his stats also. And he performed excellent on his debut for England in a test match, which is the highest form of cricket. He took 7 wickets and he scored 42 runs. I have not double checked. I think he scored 41 or 42. If it's incorrect, please bash me on social media. But he did amazing. And Bikram, as a lot of people are saying, that they haven't actually seen a debut like this where somebody takes 7 wickets and makes 40 odd runs.
Right.
For me, it's good enough. Not good enough. This is testament that he has changed. Okay. And also the fact that people like, how do we know he has changed in his life, not just on the field? Dude, you had to go all the way back to 2012. If he had, you had something else, you would have just found it, right? Isn't that common sense, mate? Isn't that common sense? So yeah, if you differ or if you want to add to that, please go on.
No, correct. Because at the beginning, you said that when these tweets, when he tweeted all these things, it was 18, and we have been through college, we have been through school, and the things we say to each other, to our friends, if someone records that conversation, and this has also happened, if someone records that canvas conversation and it is leaked, then it becomes a boys' room, thing which happened.
Which they found out it was a girl who was the perpetrator.
so it's just his only. And people are racist in real life, right? I mean, we until few years back, it was very common that we used to call Northeast people chinky, right? Now it has
become, black people, a lot of bad stuff like Habshi and all. Yeah, we still do.
So I don't know. I mean, and that's what the standards keep changing, right? Chinky was not so offensive maybe 10 years back. Now it is offensive. Now something will become offensive again in 10 years, and you cannot judge someone's conduct 10 years back and then make a judgment on how he is right now. That's not fair. I don't think so.
Fair enough. So another point that I would want to talk about is this opinion that telling white people to shut the fuck up on this particular topic. Now, what they're saying is that this awful argument says that if white people should refrain from giving their opinion on this topic unless they support Robinson's suspension from the international cricket, which is right now has happened. Now, I got to call bullshit on this thing, because that whites can't say Robinson's suspension is unfair and ridiculous because of the color of their skin. I mean, that's just pure reverse racism, and even a fucking lunatic, even a dumb fuck can actually figure that out. Now, when United Kingdom's PM, or let me call him the white boy in today's generation, Boris Johnson, remarked that Robinson's suspension was over the top, liberals shouted that, listen, PM, you are a politician, you're not a sports person, so do what you fucking paid to do, not get into this business. Now, my question to you, Bikram, is, and also I'll justify this thing, that I don't think the problem is that government is interfering. The problem is what government is saying is against what these fuckers believe in out there. Because the case in point is just a month or so ago, when the whole Super League rebel drama happened, and there was like 12 fucking teams, like the top teams, which was just wanted to break away from the mold, from UEFA and Champions League, and start their own Super League. That's when Boris Johnson and a lot of people came out, openly condemned the league, and everybody hearted the PM on Twitter, feed, Instagram, Pinterest, whatever shit is out there. And including the liberals, who are like right now calling him out and saying this is not your job, and they're telling him to shut the fuck up, they liked it. So it just proves the fact that trouble isn't who is giving an opinion. Trouble is those people who are giving an opinion does not match your opinion. Then you have a problem.
Yeah, and this has been the problem from the beginning. Now it has become so common, because now everyone has an opinion, and I mean everyone used to have opinion before also, but now everyone has a place to give their opinion, whether it matters or not, and this is what happens. And I mean, we call people leftists, we call people right wingers, extreme right winger or whatever. All these people, they never agree to each other. They never want to learn. They never want to, hear out anyone else. And I think there is a group called centrist, which both right and left wingers hate.
So sitting on the fence.
Yeah, because they're sitting on the fence. So what people can do, when you speak, when you open your mouth, you're going to it's a fact right now that when you you're opening your mouth and saying something, you're going to offend someone. I mean, we watch Joe Rogan podcast, right? Very often. And yes. the things he says, if you go down now there's no comment section, but when they used to post on YouTube, you will find a lot of people getting offended about things, and you know, and you can't work if you are just worried about everything. But now I think we'll have to be worried about all these things, at least for the future.
So on that note, because you're talking about the worry, because obviously you're also deleting everything that you ever said, because even if you said like, I like you, you just somehow feel like maybe I like you 2 years again later on, become like the word like will become like the N word. Yeah. People are like, how can you use the word like? You cannot use it. Okay. So I know how much you know about it, but Jimmy Anderson, he has deleted his tweet from 2010, and he was not 18. He was 28 years old, by the way. And then his tweet said, as we can see here, that I saw Brody's, which is Stuart Broad's new haircut, for the first time today. Not sure about it. Thought he looked like a 15-year-old lesbian. Now, to be very honest, the fact that Anderson felt compelled to delete this tweet for 11 years, also the fact for 11 years nobody ever got offended by this tweet, is a perfect metaphor for the society that we live in. Barring woke liberals and humor dead, by the way, I'm constantly calling them wokes, and now people are like, are you talking? I'm not talking about Chris Wokes, okay? Don't confuse Chris Wokes. I'm saying wokes are the woke people. That's why I said woke liberals and humor dead lesbians. Every human can see that this is a harmless and humorous tweet. It's a banter between two really close friends. That's right. Jimmy Anderson and Stuart Broad. Vikram, we are heading fast to a humorless world of stiff-faced idiots. Right. Also, I want to tell you that, I don't know if you read this, another shitstorm has happened, that where they found Joss Butler, Brandon McCollum, and I think this is another person I'm forgetting, so I don't want to say name. This is just example. They're just making fun of Indian people, how they speak English. Just like mucking around on the internet. It's like, thank you, sir, you double-handed, very nice, next time you come to us, and all that stuff. So, I just feel that is not at all offensive. It is just mucking around. We can make fun of English people, how they speak. Because that's what, if you say Farley TV, they make fun of all the people all the time. It's perfectly okay. And everybody's now shit scared. They're like, I don't know what they will bring out. And they'll say, now you're a racist.
And that has been the pattern. If we make fun of white people, no white people will come and say that you are a racist. But if we make fun of black people, because they have been under they have been under all those situations and all those
marginalized marginalized,
yeah, that's the word. So now it becomes a sensitive topic, so you have to be careful when you are talking about those people. So, but now the thing is, it's not just black people. There are different kind of people. There are different identities now. People call themselves through nouns. Like he, she, they, them,
sir,
and all that. It's really difficult. It's, I mean, for a boomer like us, I mean, are we boomer? Or yeah, I think we're boomer. Right?
No, we're not boomers. We're millennials.
Millennials.
81 onwards. 81 till 97.
So for boomers,
before.
So for boomers, this world is done. I mean, I don't think they can fit in anymore. For millennials,
well, luckily there's no internet. All boomers will be racist.
Right. And for us millennials, I think we have like 10 years until we will be out of fashion, and we'll be like, even if you say something, it will offend someone. So yeah, it's happening.
God forbid this podcast become popular. We're going to be like completely shunned from the society. Now, I have a final word on this thing. And this is going to be very fiery from my end. And I'm like, I am not going to, pull any punches here. I'm going to just go all out. So as we record this podcast, Robinson has been indefinitely suspended for international cricket pending investigation. Now, firstly, whatever the fuck the investigation is, I don't know how they do it. Do it fairly and do it at FedEx fucking speed. Because if nothing concrete or damning is found, lift the international ban immediately. Now, I'm going to pretend to be a woke person. The woke person says to me, oh, are you saying we should all forget what you said like it never fucking happened, you little piece of shit? No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying give him community service, make him the fucking poster boy inclusivity drive that it's already ongoing in England. The way forward isn't to shame, cancel and blacklist people from cricket or real world. Okay. The way forward is to keep educated Robinson. Let him become the guiding light of change, even if that cheesy as fucking sounds, as I said. Banning Ollie from any further matches than he's already been banned for one match is going to be ridiculous. But why? Because remember, don't forget this, that when we are 18, we are fucking idiots, and Robinson cannot be judged for nonsense tweets he posted almost a decade ago. The same way you cannot judge Adolf Hitler, can't be remembered by history as a brilliant upcoming artist, because that's exactly who he was when he was 18 years old, okay? He will be judged by what he did. Valmiki, Maharishi Valmiki, was a fucking dacoit in his flamboyant youth, and he was mucking around everywhere, but he transformed and he wrote what we now know as, not Bhagavad Gita, what did he write? Holy Ramayana. Okay, he wrote Holy Ramayana. That's what we remember him for. Never judge a person's character by who they were yesterday, but who they are right now, as they are, as you speak. So if we can't give people second chances, then we don't deserve the freedom of speech, which we already don't have in India, thanks to BJP, because we are hypocritical sadists who love to see someone get destroyed, and specifically someone who has worked their ass off. Because Bikram, you and I know, no matter what we do, and even if we're 20 years younger, we cannot ever be playing for India. Nobody can play for England. He must have some very special talent, and after that he must be working his ass off. For two fucking decades he's worked his ass off to get to wear the colors of his country in the highest form of cricket. Now I have a question for you, that you have a young daughter who's very young, she's like probably 3 odd years old, and I think she's already in a lot of trouble, because unless she chooses to live a life of an absolute coward who never speaks her mind, never posts anything what she believes in, never takes a risk, never uses dark humor in her entire goddamn life, because if she does, and then God forbid, because I feel we both know that she seems to be like absolutely smart, and she works her ass off and becomes a sports person or somebody important, these internet trolls, aka woke people, will find something stupid she tweeted when she was 12 and label her a racist, sexist, homophobic idiot who deserves to be deported to fucking Guantanamo Bay alongside Al-Qaeda and Taliban terrorists. And this is the world we are living in.
Right. So I would take the opportunity announce that I am hiring people for as media manager for her right now, because she's already 3 years old and she has started using phone. So I don't know what she will write and message and post. So I'm going to. So I think it's high time now that we should. Generally people used to think about, you know, their kids that, okay, we should, save money for them, or you should, get them into some training or some things from very early age. But now I think the most important thing is to have a media manager who can, where everything goes through her or him. They or them, I don't know. So
yeah, what about the people who can't afford a media manager, right? But I think it's point. You have to like monitor everything, because as a 4-year-old, she must be already sending sexist tweets to people anyway.
Yeah,
boys, I hate you. That sounds sexist to me.
Correct.
Right.
So you never know, right? That's what I was saying, that you never know in 10 years what will become offending, and not even 10 years, just in 2 years. So it's I think it's just people say, when people talk about, monitoring your kids' social media activity and all that, you should monitor them, you should guide them and all them. How would I guide them? I don't even know what is offending anymore. So I think the only option is to not let them be on social media at all, not let them, say something on social media. They can talk in among friends and stuff, and just hope that no one records that conversation and leaks it on the social media. I don't see any other way. I mean, this is going too far.
Yeah. Also, I believe you understand that's wishful thinking, right? You want to stop people from using social media, particularly the younger people. Now, my final word on this thing is that I think we got to decide what kind of world we are building and what kind of character this world has. Because I don't want to live, Bikram, in a world where we can't forgive someone and we can't give them second chances. Because everybody deserves second chances. I'm an absolute moron, and I've probably had multiple chances. Forget second chances. And Ollie Robinson, as Ollie Robinson's fake son, I'm just saying that, dude, just get over it. He didn't hit somebody. There's a difference between doing something and typing something. Okay, if I punch you in the face, you get hurt. Okay, there is no sentiment related to that. When I say something, it's how you react is completely different. He didn't really do anything. He's just like talking shit. As a teenager, he was an asshole. Okay, fine. Get over it. This is not the world we want. We're just going to cancel every motherfucker, right? Because they were 18 and they're stupid. Right now, he's an amazing talent. This is going to, every time when we watch Robinson, it will give us hope. It will give other people hope, other assholes hope, that, they can also transform their life. When he was fired from his county for unprofessional conduct, he said, all right, this is it. Either I fucking just drown or I swim, and I swim really well. And I think I have to give him credit, whatever he's done. And I watched a little bit of his bowling and batting. He looked like the real deal, and that's what everybody's saying. So let's not forget what he did, but let's make something better out of what he did. Either he can do community service, whatever, he move forward. But I think Ollie Robinson needs to come back in the English team. And that is the precedent I want. And that's the world I want to live in. And that's why this podcast was done today. And I worked really hard on this podcast. I wrote an entire article, which is on my blog. And this is our point. We're not here to make money. We are able to talk what we really believe in, and we are talking real shit. We're not saying we have to hide our, like, we can say, oh, why are we talking about my daughter? I don't want to talk about my daughter. No, we're not revealing any identity. We're just saying this is a fact of it, and he is worried, and I'm worried for that, because we don't want people to be constantly, you know, putting sensors, because Elon Musk will eventually make sensors for your face only. Maybe Google will make, so no matter what you do, the moment you say like something, it's like the sensors are getting sold on Amazon. It's like, oh, you sensor, sensitivity sensors, you know, woke sensors. What level sensor do you want? After a level, you'll be like opening your mouth, like, I can't speak. It's like, no, you cannot say anything anymore. You've been banned. You just said five different things. So yeah, and that's all, Vikram, and from my part.
Yeah, that's all from my part also. I just remembered when you talked about the sensor thing, there is a very amazing series called Black Mirror. And I think in the third or fourth season, the first episode, there is something similar. I'll write it here, which episode. So if you watch that episode, you will understand what will happen in future if we go on this path.
Yeah, please do that, because last time you said that you didn't do it. I remember on some other podcast I was watching, it was like, so even if you want to like and subscribe, please do, but don't do it. But if you want to do something, I would say, please write your opinion here. You can send me a recording also. My phone numbers are there. Everything is there. Please share us your view. And if you, do you really, what kind of world do you want to live in? That's my question to you. If anybody's listening, please tell me that, what kind of, is this the kind of world you want to live in? If this was your brother, this was somebody known to you, would you cancel this person? Will you shun him for the society for this thing? Or will you give him a chance to reform, which he's already reforming? Or will you forgive? Because I want to live in a world where people forgive and get on with life, and not castrate people for every single mistake they have made, because that's not the world I want to live in. All right, on that note, take care. Have a good rest of the weekend. I'm also traveling a little bit to Almora, and hopefully I can see more trees and one of them might fall on me. Let's see, hopefully not. All right, take
just
care.
Take a picture.
And we'll take a picture. Definitely ask him to make a picture, and it'll become very popular, and it'll go complete spiral and viral. All right, take care. Have a good evening, and we'll see you next time with, I think, which one is funny news of the week. All right, take care. Yeah. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.